Much thanks. I'll take it from here.
Walk on, girl. That's a girl. Thank you. you up.
Careful there!
Third batch of kids this month, and still no progress. To just suddenly go missing.
I'm helping you out.
Tar very much. Who are you?
Strange man he is.
Grown-ups play games too.
Get that bastard!
Oh,
Lennon.
They better not sneak up on
me. In the edge. It's what I do until the sun goes
get
down.
Back.
Now they want revenge. They're looking to trim me.
No,
but I won't let
out.
Them. Wait.
Thank you. I'm right here.
Thanks very much.
Grab him!
The piano
drag
timer.
Him out! I'll make this...
Here to help.
You really helped us, mister.
Can I join in?
Someone must be looking for him.
Jacob, how you doing?
You're over there!
Come on! You'll be back in!
tell you again!
You're about to be my first.
He's still here.
Thank you.
I've heard about you. Blighters! Do away with this nuisance.
Where are you going?
Oh my God!
Finish him off, and we'll go for a drink.
Over.
Snap his bloody neck!
Welcomes all.
Yeah.
Right there, you little thief.
We've been challenged to a fight to settle the claim on this borough.
Join me.
I'm your man.
Just step behind.
I hear you've dealt with Mr. Lynch on your own terms. Now all that stands between you and the Strand are his ever-loyal cronies. Good luck.
belongs to us! Welcome to Grog Street! It's time to fight! Ladies and gentlemen, we are Jacob and Evie Fry, and as of this moment, you all work for us.
You're not my usual driver. Rupert!
Ah! here. Come. What's this then?
Don't struggle.
You a cop or something?
Quiet down, Mr. Linton. Hush now.
A lady? I've never fought a lady before. You are here to fight me, are you not?
I'm here to take you to the police.
Let me go. Let's have a real tussle, shall we? Turn around and put up your fists. Come on.
Sure. If you'd just come with me first.
Can't we have 5 minutes?
There's something going on.
You can't see anything either.
We're too far away.
What's all the ruckus?
Easy, girl. Slowly. I could use your help.
Of course, if I...
You lead.
I always knew the Rooks were strong, but I didn't think you stood a chance against the Bludger. There isn't much standing in your way now.
This borough is ours for the taking. Jacob Fry, and as of this moment, you all work for us.
The money.
Why don't I come over there?
my newly honored friends.
Your Majesty.
We understand that with Crawford Starrick gone, a certain secret society finds itself searching for leadership. An upstart faction seeks to enter London and seize power.
Do you feel your life is in danger, ma'am?
No. Rather, I fear that the people of this grand city may suffer. I call upon you to foil this traitorous plot.
You can depend on us.
You will meet my loyal aide at the docks for instructions. Your work begins immediately.
I am Elfred Fleming. I run Her Majesty's Secret Service. First things first, we need to clear the area of anything that might alarm the enemy. Like that police carriage. Would you kindly dispose of it?
There you are.
My agents are here, disguised as civilians. Get them into position for our ambush. A ship will soon arrive from Boston. Its cargo, dynamite. Its crew, Templar. What say you to greeting it with an ambush?
If we must, we must.
Don't
serves you right.
On your way, then.
That's their leader. I want him brought to me at the station, alive.
Would you care to tell me your plans?
Go to hell!
Now.
Steric may be dead and gone, but the Templar Order will never die. We will rise again, like a phoenix from the ashes, and bring the world to its knees.
Yes, well, best of luck with that.
Looks interesting.
I wonder what's happening over there.
Thank you. I'll carry on from here. My people are recovering their explosive cargo. You did fine work today. I will have a chat with our distinguished guest here to see what schemes he and his friends are brewing.
Do let me know if he says anything interesting.
Of course.
Restores some of my faith in humanity. My God, thank you. This restores some of my faith in humanity.
Thank you.
those are the largest ships I've ever seen.
Why don't I rip your empty head off?
One more but a pauper's pit.
Dead. Dead as a fool.
You shouldn't be here.
Get your power to the pit!
Don't bite that now, will you?
There's been a spate of rather intriguing thefts about town recently.
Robberies in London are hardly supernatural events.
They look like common robberies at first, but these perpetrators have all claimed to have been under the influence of some supernatural power. I'm not so foolish as to forget that criminals will spin any yarn to avoid the law. However, these thieves all proffer the same defense. They say they were being controlled by a demon. Will you make some inquiries? One of our demon-possessed mobsmen is being held behind bars at this very moment. You may want to begin your search there.
But to marry a milkman, she didn't feel inclined.
I wonder if anyone's been killed.
Never a quiet moment in London, I suppose.
What's that man done?
Huh? Robbed the pawnbrokers down the road.
Demon made me do it. I can't remember much. That's what's so queer. I've never stolen anything in my life before.
Let's pretend that I believe you. Tell me who made you do it.
All I can recall is a silver watch. swinging in midair. It was held by someone or something. A dark presence whispering. I could only see its eyes. A demon.
I'll need to verify this with the shopkeeper. What can you tell me about the robbery?
There's not much to say. Most of the items did come from the same seller, Enzio Capelli, Sorcerer Supreme, a famous showman from Italy. Several weeks ago, he was forced to pawn his family heirlooms, debts. I have the address of the last person who redeemed something of his, a lovely pearl necklace. That helpful?
Not again! Stop her! Stop! Somebody stop that thief!
Something from a pawn shop.
It's all very hazy, but I remember something silver flashing in front of my eyes. Then I heard a sort of bell. Next thing I know, I'm here with you.
My only lead is this mysterious buyer. This chap might lead me to the demon.
I'm here! Lock on, girl.
I'm not interested in wasting my time on you. Keep moving.
Ooh.
argy-bargy about, then?
Don't waste someone else's time!
Trousers clean, everyone's gonna think I'm a tramp!
Oh, you're in bed with a bouquet of magnolias, meaning a lost love.
You better keep your distance if you know what's good for you. Where are you going? Answer me!
My dogs are angry. I'm all out of fresh meat.
You follow.
There, girl. Good girl. Walk on, my beauty. Good girl.
To give you the necklace now.
Mr. Enzio Capelli, I presume? So you're responsible for the theft of your own jewels?
You are very much mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
You are very much mistaken. And now you are so very, very tired, aren't you?
Yes, I'm very, very tired.
Now, you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
My goodness, what foul behavior.
What's going on? Where am I?
You've been arrested for theft. How very intriguing.
I can't remember a jot of it.
Let's get you out of here. I've pulled a few strings, and they won't prosecute on account of your losing your mind. Be free, little chicken.
You ought to taste it.
Well, I get you, or are you from Tower Three?
Salix Alpha. There it is.
I didn't know you had a twin sister, Mr. Fry.
Evie Fry, sir. It's a pleasure.
Usually I would reciprocate the sentiment, Miss Fry, but today I'm afraid nothing will bring me pleasure.
What's troubling you, sir?
I am used to people challenging my ideas. In fact, I live for it, the cut and thrust of spirited debate. Lately, however, attacks against my reputation have taken a darker turn. Threats of violence against my person and against my colleagues. I do not wish anyone to be hurt because of my research.
You helped me with Staric syrup. I am in your debt.
We help each other, sir.
My brother and I will make sure that you can continue your work in peace.
What do you know of bones?
I know how much pressure it takes to shatter, snap, or splinter one.
Perhaps it would be simpler if I just explained the situation. A few days ago, a German colleague, Dr. Schwartz, sent me a telegram. He informed me he was on his way to London to deliver a very important fossil, you see. In fact, he should arrive at Charing Cross any moment now. Would you ensure no harm comes to him?
I'll bring Dr. Schwartz and that fossil to you, Mr. Darwin.
Splendid. But please do be careful. Please, hurry. I fear Dr. Schwartz might be in danger.
Meaning of this?
I'm collecting you and your precious cargo for our friend Mr. Darwin. Just act naturally.
Right. So, how is your father? By which I mean my dear brother Frank, with whom I grew up, of course. Oh, splendid! Wonderful to hear! I'll do my best not to call attention to how remiss he was in forgetting to warn me about the delicate situation which brings me here today.
What are these fuckers up to?
To know what the bugger looks like.
What's happening over there?
Stay back, Doctor!
The German doctor is supposed
to look
like anyone.
Is that him?
Wouldn't hurt to know what the bugger looks like. Like fun.
What is the meaning of this?
Collecting you and your precious cargo for our friend Mr. Darwin. Just act naturally.
Right. So, how is your father? By which I mean my dear brother Frank, with whom I grew up, of course.
Oh, splendid! Wonderful to hear! I'll do my best not to call attention to how remiss he was in forgetting to warn me about the delicate situation which brings me here today.
Like finding a needle in a haystack. Step
back, Doctor!
Wouldn't hurt to know what the bugger looks like. Wouldn't hurt to know what the bugger looks like. Like finding a needle in a haystack, this is. Wouldn't hurt to know what the fucker looks like.
Never got on the train.
Darwin's fate is sealed. Goodbye, assassin. I did so enjoy meeting you. Darwin must be silent.
I'll break you off the road. Stop, and I might let you live. Where do you think you're going?
Now to take this fossil to Darwin.
At last, my heart hasn't stopped pounding. You have it? Wonderful. But where is Dr. Schwartz?
Most likely dead, I'm afraid. He never left Germany. At least I managed to get the fossil back.
Dear Lord, I should tell you, I was recently approached by men who sought to purchase all my research on the condition I work only for them. Obviously, I refused. Scientific knowledge cannot be bought. It belongs to everyone. Let these villains do their worst.